गुड इवनिंग ऑल ऑफ यू। तो इन कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ आवर लास्ट लेक्चर टुडे विल स्टार्ट विद द मेजर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ कन्वेंशनल मशीन एज वेल एज नॉन कन्वेंशनल मशीन। बिकॉज लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट व्हाई वी डू नीड आवर मशीन प्रोसेसेस। ओके ऑन द सेशन characteristics about the conventional machining or our we can call traditional machining. And that first is the microscopic chip formation. Okay, as we have observed many times, generally while doing the machining operation, okay, using the our conventional machining, we are getting microscopic chip formation. Okay, whatever the material removed from the workpiece, no, that is in the form of microscopic chip. Okay. Again, for the conventional machining, for metal removal, we need a cutting force. Okay, and that cutting force usually it comes from the energy driven, like from mechanical only, because we are applying the force. Then and then only, our cutting tool will move towards the your workpiece, and through that that edged cutting tool, metal removal process will start. Okay, so metal removal takes place due to application of cutting force. Okay, and there energy domain that can be classified as a mechanical domain. Okay, then a very important point or a major character about the conventional or traditional machining, we can call that whatever the cutting tool we are using for the conventional machining process, no, its hardness should be larger than the workpiece. So that is a major. So in short, I can call cutting tool hardness. Cutting tool should be harder than the workpiece. Okay, as well as in the conventional machining, as we know that there is always physical contact between your tool. Okay, maybe a tip of tool and your workpiece. Okay, from where you want to remove the material. So these are the major characteristics of conventional. Now we'll move towards the major characteristics of non-conventional or non-traditional machining. Okay, so in that, whatever material we are going to remove from your workpiece using the any conventional non-conventional machining method, that is always in the form of small microchip. Okay. So, or even sometime if you take the example of EDM or laser cutting, there is no chip formation. Okay, so here I have written, it may be sometime we will get the chip formation or even no chip formation. Then as we come from got the point from the our that why to go for advanced machine, that we do not or we no need to go for the physical tool. Okay, so for non-conventional machining, I can say we do not require any physical tool. Then next point will be that whatever the tool is there, so there is no barrier about the its hardness. Okay, tool need not be harder than the workpiece. Okay, this is major difference between the conventional and non-conventional. Okay, tool need not be harder than your workpiece. Okay. And the most important characteristic about the non-traditional machining is that here we are going to use using different kinds of or different energy domain, okay, for providing the machining, or we can call to remove the material from the workpiece. So whatever the third point and fourth one is, that is important. Okay, so need not be harder than the workpiece. Okay, this is a, that means we do not have any barrier about the tool strength, or we can say in another word, no need to go for the harder tool. Okay, then here we are using different kinds of energy or different energy domain we are using for providing the machining. Okay, and depend on depth we have different types of non-conventional machining. Okay, for example, here itself I can say if you use abrasive particle, okay, and if you use the
kinetic energy of that average particle. Then that process is called average jet machine. If you use water, then it is called water jet machine. Like that, if you use the electrical energy, then electric discharge machine. If you use chemical energy, then chemical machine. Okay, so like that. Again, if you use thermal energy, okay, along with the electrical energy, then laser beam machine, electron beam machine. These are the different non-conventional machining processes. Okay. Now, as already we have discussed about the advanced machining, where to go for advanced machining. So similar, as per the syllabus, we have the point that is need for non-conventional machining. Okay. Now, as we know that whatever our conventional machines are there now, that are specific to the requirement, that requirement of industry, okay, from last over the decade. But for whatever new coming materials are there, or we can call new exotic work materials are there now, as well as we can call innovative geometric design of your product and the OEM component. So that are their requirement, it is not fulfilled by the our conventional machining process. Okay, so they are putting a lot of pressure on our capability of our conventional machining process. Okay, because using conventional machining, we cannot go for the machining of new exotic work material, or we can call for innovative geometry, the geometry of your product. Okay, so there is some limitations of capability of our conventional machine process. Okay, and to manufacture this component with desired tolerances, we require some new process. So this will lead to the our development as well as we can call establishment of advanced machining processes or non-traditional machining processes in the industry. Okay, so whatever our non-traditional machining processes are there in the industry, they are efficient as well as economic alternatives to your conventional machine. So in general, this is a need for our non-conventional machine. Also, with the development of in this non-traditional machining process, you know, currently there are first choice in the industry. Okay, not just alternate. In industry, they are referring as a first choice of this non-traditional machining. Okay, not only alternative to conventional machining, because whatever we in the industry, whatever there is a certain technical requirements are there now. So to fulfill that, there is a need of development in the non-traditional machining process. Due to that, they are going for micro machining also. Okay, along with the this advanced machining process. Okay, that is new. Now, whatever the I have mentioned the points in this slide now. So these are the examples. Okay, that are provided where the non-traditional machining processes are preferred over the our conventional machining process. Okay, so these are the examples. Okay, where non-traditional machining processes are preferred over the conventional machining process. Now, if you see in the slide, on the slide. So first example I have given that integrate shape the blindfold. Okay, again in that we can take the example that if we want to drill a square hole of 10 mm by 15 mm, okay, along with depth of 30 mm, so it is not possible using our conventional machine. So to drill this integrate shape the blindfold, we need only non-conventional machining or an advanced machining process. Okay. Integrate means what? In Marathi we can call Gunta-Gunti Miller. Okay. Then next need is that whatever the materials are there which are difficult to machine. So to machine the material which are difficult to machine,
we need only advanced machine processing. Okay, so in that again, for example, okay, same example as I have mentioned above, no? But if the material of work is in Cornell or titanium alloys or carbide, then it is not possible using our conventional machining. Okay, because the whatever the materials are there, no, in Cornell or the carbide or some alloy, they are very hard, okay, and they are difficult to machine. Okay, so for that purpose we need non-conventional machining. Again, in that material, if you want to go for drilling of the square hole of fine hole, that is 15 mm by 15 mm, then it is difficult. So for that non-conventional machining, it is sufficient. Again, what are the low stress grinding is there, no? So for that purpose, again, now this low stress grinding, it is not possible using our traditional machining. What are the electrochemical we can use for grinding? So in combining, that is grinding is traditional. Okay, that will be used in the electrochemical machine. Then it is preferred for the low stress grinding as compared to our conventional grinding. Okay. Then for deep hole with a small hole diameter, no? For that purpose, now using our conventional machining, maybe this deep hole with a small diameter, small hole diameter, so that activity may be performed using the our example. If the hole diameter is 1.5 mm and also that ratio of inner and outer diameter maybe 20, then it is that small not possible using our, or it may be difficult using the conventional machining. So we need to go for conventional, we need to go for non-conventional machining process. Okay, then again, as we, I have mentioned that nowadays there are new exotic materials are there, new innovative materials are coming, like that composite materials are there. Okay, in metallurgy we know that composite having the separate category. So to machine, for machining of these composite materials, we need advanced machining processing. Okay, so these are the different needs from which we can say we have to go with the our non-conventional machining or non-traditional machining process. Okay, and now if you see, now after getting the information about the advanced machining process, we need to move for the its classification. Okay, because we know that energy domain, it is important for the our non-conventional machining process. So whatever the classification is there, depend on the energy domain. There are so in that we have the category depend on the energy domain. So mechanical domain, that is mechanical energy based. Non-conventional machining process, these are that are different than thermal energy based or thermoelectric we can call, then electrochemical energy based processes are there, then chemical is there. Okay, now in that again, before that depend on the what are the workpiece material is there now? That means what are the properties of workpiece is there that workpiece to be machined now? So again, based on that also, we have the classification. Okay. So classification may be depend on the different criteria. In that again, I can say what are the advanced machining processes are there now? They use different kinds of energy in their direct form. Okay. For example, if you take the example of लेजर बीम एनर्जी और इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम एनर्जी और आयन बीम एनर्जी, इलेक्ट्रिक स्पार्क एनर्जी एंड सो ऑन. सो डिपेंड ऑन दैट वी हैव द डिफरेंट क्लासिफिकेशन. इन जनरल व्हाट आर द मेटल रिमूवल इज देयर नो इन दिस एडवांस मशीन प्रोसेसेस, दैट इज नॉर्मली इट इज वेरी लो. ओके बट डेफिनेटली व्हाट आर द क्वालिटी ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट इज देयर नो, इट इज बेटर देन द व्हाट यू कैन अचीव बाय आवर कन्वेंशनल मशीन प्रोसेस. ओके सो हाउ एवर इन दिस एडवांस मशीन प्रोसेसेस नो, व्हाट आर द इनिशियल कॉस्ट इज देयर, दैट इज ऑल्सो very high as compared to conventional machining process. Okay, for example if you take a good lathe, okay, then that lathe can be brought for about I can say 10 lakh or so. But if you go or to buy a simple electrochemical machining or EDM machine, then it will not come less than the euro 20 lakh. Okay, so on the other hand, whatever the electron beam machine there, again, for electron beam machine, cost is more than the 50 lakh. Okay, so here, whatever the initial investment is there, that is very high for the advanced machining processes, okay, or that machinery. Okay, now come to our point, that classification. So, classification of this non-traditional machining process can be done based on the different criteria. Okay, so in that one of the criteria is the, firstly I will tell the type of workpiece to be machine. Okay, type of workpiece to be machine. So there are certain processes which are applicable only for the electrical conductive metal. Okay, that means if your workpiece is electrically conductive metal, then and then only your some advanced machining processes can be used. Okay. Now in that I can tell example that electrochemical machining or electric discharge machining or even electron beam machining. Okay, not always. So these processes you can use only for the electrical conductive material. Okay. So this may be one category of your process. Again, there are certain processes which are applicable for both your electrically conductive as well as electrical non-conductive material. Okay, if your workpiece material is electrically conductive as well as for example if you take another way electric non-conductive also, then some processes just like ultrasonic machining, abrasive jet machining, laser beam machining also. So using that machining processes you can do machining operation. Okay, again there are certain processes which are very good for non-magnetic materials only. Okay. So this is again third category, depend on based on the properties of work material to be machine. Okay. So certain processes which are very good for non-magnetic materials. Okay. While they are not so good, I can say, for magnetic material. And those processes are like magnetic abrasive finishing, EMAF, then magnetorheological finishing. Okay, these two processes are not in our syllabus, but for your information, I am telling this category where whatever the magnetic field is used, no, for assisting the process that we will get from that process only. So there are again certain processes are there whose performance is totally different upon the thermal properties of your workpiece material. Okay, now the processes whose performance is totally depend on the thermal properties of your workpiece material, like now thermal property means which are that property, like thermal conductivity, specific heat, then reflectivity. Okay, in that again optical or thermal, etc. Okay, so these properties plays an important role in certain processes, especially in case of I can say laser beam machining. Okay, so if the component has a high reflectivity in case of laser beam machining, then that laser beam machining cannot be work sufficiently. Okay, if the component have high reflectivity. Now on the other side, other hand, I can say out of the conventional machining is machining process are there, no, like turning, milling, drilling, etc. So they do not have any such kind of constraint about the properties of work workpiece. Okay, so only in case of this our non-conventional machining process, you can use mechanical type of advanced machining processes and mechanical type of finishing process also for all kind of materials. Mechanical machining processes are different, and mechanical type finishing processes are different. Again, whatever the chemical and electrochemical machining processes are, then that are also can be used for electrically conductive material. Okay, then however, whatever the your electroconductivity in chemical machining, so that is not required for chemical machining, that electric conductive property. Okay, again, if you take the in case of electrically non-conductive material, so again for that category also different kinds of conventional machining processes like turning, milling, or drilling can be used. Okay, for electrically non-conductive, and for the again further I can say for non-conductive material, mechanical type of machining like edge abrasive jet machining, ultrasonic machining, abrasive water jet machining, abrasive flow machining, then water jet machining, biomagnetic abrasive finishing process can be used. Okay, again in case of thermoelectric advanced machining process, thermoelectric advanced machining process, in that again laser beam machining, LBM, then plasma arc machining, PAM, ion beam machining, IBM can be used for the thermoelectric. Okay, again for chemical advanced machining processes and biochemical machining processes, so that machining processes you can use for the material, it may be electrically conductive or non-conductive material. Okay, so that was the classification based on the your properties of the material, that workpiece material versus to the machine. Now come to the main classification of this non-traditional machine, that is classification of this various non-traditional machine process based on the which kind of energy they are using for the material removal process. Okay, so let us discuss the classification of various advanced machining processes based on the kind different kind of energy used. Okay, in that here I have mentioned that these can be classified according to the source of energy used to generate such a machining action. Okay, now source of energy or domain, I can say mechanical energy is there, thermal energy is there, then electrochemical is there, electrochemical energy is there, and again there is a biochemical also there. Okay, in the classification, but as per our syllabus we should concentrate on this mechanical, thermal, chemical and electrochemical only. Okay, now in that again, okay, if you take the mechanically energy based process, now mechanically energy, then basic question will arise that how the material removal process will happen using the mechanical energy or in this mechanical process. So there a erosion of your workpiece material will be happen by high velocity stream of your abrasive or your fluid or both. Okay, so whatever the erosion is there, that is the typical form of your mechanical action. Okay, so due to erosion of your workpiece, material removal will happen. Now how that erosion is going to happen? So okay, so for erosion purpose to happen, that erosion we need high velocity stream of some fluid. Okay, now in that if you use high velocity stream of abrasive, then the abrasive jet machining it is called. And if you use water, high velocity stream of water or water jet, then that process is called water jet machining. Okay, and if you combine use, then abrasive water jet machining. So for mechanically energy based process, erosion action is important, because due to the erosion action only material is removed from your workpiece. Okay, now in that again, which are the different types mechanically energy already I have mentioned that abbreviated machining, ultrasonic machining, in short, abbreviated machining, AJM. Then water jet machining, WJM. Then water abrasive water jet machining, AWJM. And lastly, water ultrasonic machining, USM. Okay. So I repeat, erosion of work material by high velocity stream of abrasive or fluid or both. Okay, it is a typical form of mechanical action. Okay. Now let us look for the second energy, that is thermal energy. So this is second group, that is thermal energy based on non-conductive machining. Now in that, what are the thermal energies there now? So that thermal energy is applied to a very small portion of your workpiece surface. Okay, so thermal energy is applied to a very small portion of workpiece, and that will that causing that portion. What are the metal we want to remove from that portion? So there, due to the application of thermal energy, that heat energy, fusion, and that vaporization of material will be happen. Okay. Now, from where we'll get this thermal energy or that heat energy? So to get that thermal energy or that thermal energy, it is generated by conversion of the electric energy. So this group is called electrothermal energy or thermoelectric energy based process. Okay. So I repeat, here material is removed using heat energy. Now heat energy we need to generate from your electric energy. Now how heat energy is going to remove the material? So if you use continuously that heat on your workpiece surface, a small portion, then due to the fusion and the vaporization, that means the melting, that fusion and that vaporization will be happen from that your on that your portion. Okay, from where we want to remove. Okay, so please note on this that fusion and vaporization of the material is the action of your material removal. Okay, in this, in the case of this thermal energy or electrothermal based processing. Okay, now next is the electrochemical energy based processing. Now electrochemical means what? Here is simple. Okay, here what are the electrochemical dissolution is done. So due to that dissolution, material removal will be happen. Now we know that electroplating. So reverse of that electroplating is that mechanism of electroplating. We take in a reverse way, then electrochemical dissolution will happen. So that is the main action in this group. Okay. So mechanism of the electrochemical machine is the reverse of electroplating. Okay, the reverse of electroplating. Now here again, I forgot to mention the good example of thermal energy based process, that whatever your electric discharge machine is there, wire cut electric discharge machine is there, laser beam machine, all that again electro beam machine, plasma arc machine is there, then ion beam machine. So that are belong to the thermal energy based, I can say, or thermoelectric energy based process. Okay. And then electrochemical process. In that, your electrochemical machining will come, then electrochemical grinding, okay, ECG, ECM, then electrojet drilling is there. Okay, that has replaced actually electrojet. Okay. Then we have the last one, that is chemical. Okay, so in that again, due to the chemical attack of a certain acid, no, we can remove the material from the workpiece. Okay, so there chemical dissolution is important, and due to that chemical, if for example, one small if you take the plate of copper and if you put in any chemical, okay, again whatever the chemical is there, that must be react on your working. So due to that reaction, matter will be removed from the work piece of work, from the portion of work piece. Okay, so each and is used to attack on your work piece. So that certain chemical we can call, it is called etchant. Okay, so in this chemical machine, actually chemicals are selected, okay, to remove the material from your portion of work piece or work art. Okay, now from where we want to remove the material using the chemical machine, no? So from where material you want to remove, on that portion we are keeping the etchant. Etchant means one of the chemical. Now which type of etchant is used and different things are that we are going to see at the time of chemical. But the portion from where we want to remove the material using chemical machine, so on that portion we are keeping or we are pasting chemical, it is called etchant. Okay, so that etchant will try to will try to act react on that your work. Okay, and another one, so on your work piece maybe other portion will be there, okay, from where you do not want to remove the material, so that must be protected from the etchant. So the protection which are used on your work piece from where you do not want to remove the material, so that protection, it is called the masker. Okay, etchant and masker. Please remember. Now, here in short, here you can see under mechanical, which are the machining and which are finishing process. Then in the group of thermoelectric, which are the different processes. In the group of chemical and chemical, which are the different processes. You can see. Okay. If you have the notebook and pen, then please write down this within 1 minute. Just write down, because this is important. Okay. Whatever we have the syllabus for the chapter number 2 to 5. We have the different syllabus, except this biochemical machining and except this finishing process. Okay, but for your knowledge of biochemistry, biochemistry, it is also part of our advanced machining process. Okay, in our syllabus we don't have this finishing process. Okay, if you want to go in detail about the finishing process, now you can refer the reference book. Okay, advanced machining process by the VKJ. Okay, in our syllabus we have the AJM, the WJM, then USM, AWJM, then this LBM, EBM, EDM, okay, IBM, then CAM, ECM, ECG, PCM, CHM, the all portion we have in our syllabus. So now one by one we are going in detail about the working principle about each and every. Okay, that's called overwork the non conventional machine process. Within 1 minute, please write down, this is important. Have got this point? Okay, how this classification is then based on the energy domain which is used for machining action. Okay, or we can call according to the source of energy which is used to generate such a machining action. Now, here important part is that as we know that our advanced machine processes or non-conventional machine processes, we are divided into three normally basic three categories. One is the mechanical, then this second is the thermoelectric, and the third is the chemical and electrochemical machining processes. But here important is that none of these processes is best under all machining processes. Na? Due to this point only, I have one for that classification based on the properties of your work. Okay? So please remember that none of these processes is best under all machining situations. Okay, so some of our some of them can be used only for related conductive material, while some of this can be used for non-conductive material, while other can be used for both related conductive and as well as non-conductive material. So for some cases there may be condition of the your thermal conductor also. So depend on that situation or depend on the property of work is you need to create the best one or best to suited non-conventional machining process. Okay, and the whatever the performance of these processes are there, no? So the performance of some of these processes is not very good. Okay, please listen carefully. Okay, whatever the performance of some of these processes, it is not very good. Now performance is what? Your surface finish, or maybe firstly you have can take the material removal. Okay, in some cases surface finish is good, but material removal is very less. Okay, in some cases MRR is very good, but surface finish may be not good. Like that. So performance of some process is not good, while machining material, okay, like aluminum having high thermal conductivity. Okay, also these machining processes have there are some distinct characteristics, okay, or we can call some features also. Okay, so that we are going to see one by one. Okay, so whatever the selection of this all from this all machining process, no, that should be done very accurately as well, I can say appropriately. Okay, so selection of this appropriate machining process for a given situation, okay, or we can call as per the product requirement, that is very important. Okay, so to select one test process out of this all, it is very important, and to get one best out of this, you should have the knowledge of all process, then and only you can choose one best. Okay, now whatever the I have mentioned, the mechanical advanced machining process, no? Like your average jet machining, AJM it's called, ultrasonic machining, USAM, and water jet machining. So they have some they have developed, okay, they have developed, but with some limited success only. Okay, average jet machining have some limitation, then ultrasonic machining have some limitation, again water jet machining have some limitation. Okay, and the most important is that chemical energy is used, sorry, mechanical energy is used to remove the material. We let again, or we can call here kinetic energy, chemical mechanical energy means what? Kinetic energy of either your average particle or water jet. Okay, it is used. Okay, for what purpose? To remove the material from where? From the your workpiece. So if you use the kinetic energy of average particle, the kinetic energy of average particle means what? That velocity of your average jet. Okay, when it will strike to your workpiece, no, then and then only erosion action will take place and material removal will be happening. Okay, so here kinetic energy of your average particle or water jet. In case of water jet, must be water jet. Kinetic energy of water jet. It is used utilized for removal of material from the workpiece. Now in case of average water jet machine, you know, that is called AWJM, here also we use a kinetic energy. Okay, for this average water jet machine also uses kinetic energy of your abrasive particle, but here that abrasive particle will flow along with the water jet. So due to that only we have combined that abrasive and water jet. So kinetic energy of abrasive particles flowing along with water jet, it is used to remove the mud. Okay, and it to consider the finishing, no, finishing process under the mechanical group. Then magnetic abrasive finishing is there. Okay, that is another process in which magnetic abrasive brush it is used or it is utilized to reduce the surface to reduce the surface irregularities. Okay, from the whatever the pre-machined surface is there. No? So it's a new finishing process. It is called abrasive flow machine. We can call it is also recently developed process. Okay. However, the what are the performance of these processes are there? No, it is totally depend upon the hardness, strength, and another physical and mechanical properties of your working. Okay. So what is really needed is the your development of machining method. Okay. Whose performance is unaffected by the your physical or metallurgical and mechanical properties of workpiece. That point also we need to consider. So what are the limitations of this first group is there, no? Okay, that is overcome by the your second group. Okay. So what are the thermoelectric methods are there, no? So they are able to overcome the some barriers or drawback of your mechanical energy based process. So therefore we can call thermoelectric process as well as your that last group electrochemical process are more and more deployed in the metal working industry. Okay. Now in this second group, no, that in electric method, thermoelectric process or method, here energy, what are the our energy is there, no, that electric energy normally it is supplied in the form of heat. That means that heat electric energy is converted into the heat. Okay, now again that heat, if it is in the form of plasma, no, then your plasma arc machining will be there. If your heat is in the form of light, then laser beam machining will be there. If your heat it is in the form of electron bombardment, then electron beam machining will be there. So like depending on the form of heat is there, no, what are the forms of heat is there, no, so depending on that your thermoelectric processes are divided. Okay, like laser beam, electron beam, plasma. Okay, but here what are the energy is there, no? So that energy is concentrated normally onto the your small area of your workpiece. Okay, and that when if you concentrate the heat on your small portion of or small area of your process, no? So then that would result in your that melting or vaporization, and in some cases melting as well as both that your vaporization will be there. And due to that action, melting and vaporization, so due to that only metal remove will be happen. Now in case of the if you take the plasma arc machine, no? So that normally that plasma arc machine has been identified as a RAP machining process, huh? Plasma arc machining process has been identified as RAP machining process. In other way, in another side, whatever our laser beam machining is there, no, as well as the electron beam machining, that are very good. Okay, or we can say good enough for making very fine cuts and holes. Okay, our workpiece. Okay, and however the another category is there, that another process, that is electric discharge machining. Okay, so that is a process which is capable of machining the materials economically as well as accurately. And this process is normally used or widely used for machining hard and tough. But electrical conductive material should be there. Okay, so about EDM, that is. So, and again the drawback or the limitation of this electric discharge machine is that it is unsuitable or not suitable for many applications where very good surface finish, low damage to the machine surface, and I can call high material removal rate is, you know, if these are the requirements will be there, no? So that time this EDM machine is not suitable. So I can say the mechanical and thermoelectric processes of this advanced machine process, they do not offer any satisfactory solution to some of the problems, some of the problems of your machining, which are the materials were difficult to machine. So for that, in some cases, these processes also are not give the satisfactory solution. Okay. Again, if you talk about the in detail about the this third group, no, that is EO2 chemical and chemical. In that again, that chemical process. So that I will repeat once again that chemical process is normal. So eating process normal, you know, which have very narrow range of application mainly. Your what do you call ingrowing operation? It normally it's carried out using the chemical machine, but here material removal rate is very low, okay, and there is difficulty in finding the suitable agent also for a given work. Okay, so because whatever the properties are there not your work is, so depending on that property you need to select the agent during the chemical machine. So there is a limitation of this chemical machine also. Then electrochemical machining is there also, that ECM. It has a wide variety of application. Okay, so it is normally controlled controlled by anodic dissolution process. Okay, so that leads to a high metal removal rate. Okay, again which is independent of any physical and mechanical properties of your work. Okay, but here one condition again is there for ECM, that is your work metal should be electric conductive. Okay, so again in this ECM process there is no tool wear. Okay, then again no residual traces, then thermal damage, whatever the it is caused due to work with metal, no, so that will not be issue of issue in this ECM. Okay, there is also no burr on the your machinery. Okay, so in some cases your advanced machine process cannot be fully replaced by the conventional machine process, so that point also we need to take into consideration. Okay, so while selecting the process which is you are going to use now, so some factors you should be take into the account, that now which are factors while select which are factors which from that factor we can select the your best suitable process. So that factor means your process capability, then physical parameter, then shape to be machine, and some properties of your workpiece material to be cut, and lastly economic of your process. So this point generally you need to consider while selecting the process. Okay, so this is about the classification. Okay, in the next lecture we'll go by one by one again in detail. Okay, okay. Actually chapter one is started. Okay, now again to overcome the some we can call difficulties or the limitations of this advanced machine processes. So to further enhance the capability of these processes, machine processes, no? We can go for combination of two or more than two machine processes. Okay, so that will get the or we can take the advantages of this worthiness of the your constituent process. Okay, so if you go combination of two or more than two advanced machine processes, then whatever we get new process, it is called the hybrid process. Okay, so that also take into the account. Okay, for example, if you combine your conventional granite process, okay, along with your that electrochemical machining, then it is called electrochemical granite process. Okay, so electrochemical machine plus your conventional will get the electrochemical grinding. Like that, another process like electrochemical spark machining is there. Okay, then electrochemical arc machining is there. Electrochemical arc machining, then electrodischarge abrasive machining is there. So these are the some hybrid processes also. There. Okay. Now, next lecture we'll discuss one by one. Sorry, first we will go for difference, and then we'll go for over. Okay, now let me take attendance, then you can
in this lecture. Okay. Now you can write your roll number in the chat box.